Welcome to Top 5 Final Fantasy. I'm Nokwe.
And I'm Peter.
And
we
are
the
Birds
of
Play!
For the first time in Top 5 Final Fantasy history, we're going to be showing both sides of the coin. The best and the worst. By ranking the top 5 rad dads, as well as the top 5 bad dads from the series. All the while exploring the concept of fatherhood in Final Fantasy.
If you end up liking the video, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already and join the Birdhouse, becoming a part of our growing Final Fantasy family. But without further ado, let's talk about dads.
Why aren't you proud of me, Dad?
Bad Dad number 5. Jecht from Final Fantasy X. As a father, Jecht is emotionally abusive to his son Tidus, giving him the nickname Crybaby and frequently belittling him. Somewhat of a narcissist, Jecht is arrogant and gives off the impression that he cares more about his Blitzball career than he does about his own son, not to mention his alcoholic tendencies, immortalized in his attacking of the shoe puff. Jecht's age is unknown, but judging by the fact that he is an athlete in his prime when he disappeared, one could imagine that he had Tidus when he was still relatively young. Therefore, he might still have had a fair bit of growing up to do, and like many such parents, he matures along with his child. Jecht's methods may have been controversial, but he does seem to genuinely care for Tidus. His bullying, at least, partly intended to desensitize him to adversity and to toughen him up. No matter how good his intentions may have been, however, his actions were misguided. And no matter the ultimate effect they may have had on Tidus, Jecht still failed to create a nurturing environment for his child at a young age.
Rad Dad number 5. Bartholomew Astime from Final Fantasy XIII. Better known as Hope's dad, Bartholomew is a minor character that nevertheless manages to leave a big impression, at least on the spectrum of Final Fantasy fathers. For someone on the positive side of fatherhood, however, his relationship with Hope is fairly strained, due to him generally not being able to express his love for his wife and son. This leads Hope to being nervous about returning home, since he doesn't know how his father will react to all that has happened and to what he has become. I'm sure that many can relate, even though most problems a child might be afraid to bring home to its parents are more mundane than what Hope is going through. As the lost son returns home, however, he is welcomed with open arms and made perfectly aware that this is his home and that he will always be welcome there. Aww.
Bad Dad number 4. Barret from Final Fantasy VII. An adoptive father to Marlene, Barret is a man that might benefit from rethinking his priorities, especially since his daughter has already lost one father. It might be considered healthy for a parent and child to get some time apart, the child adjusting to new circumstances as is left in the care of another, and the parent getting some much-needed me time to work on themselves. However, when you leave your child in a bar in the slums, and your me time consists mainly of terrorist activity, your crowning achievement being blowing up a power plant, then you're probably doing something wrong. Not to mention Barret's decision to leave Marlene behind with a woman he barely knows as he goes on in his own adventure. Take a seat on the school board, Barret, or an active role in local government, affect change in your neighborhood, and leave the planet saving to someone else.
Rad Dad number 4. Barret from Final Fantasy VII. Barret might not be the perfect dad, but he is a very loving father, and proves that it isn't necessary to be related by blood in order to care for a child as your own. Also, he believes that what he is doing is at least partly for Marlene's sake, even though it's also partly fueled by the hope for revenge against Shinra. If you're going to take parenting advice from Barret, maybe you should leave it at just how to love your child, and find other role models for how to be there for your child.
Bad Dad number 3. Dr. Cid from Final Fantasy XII. Cidolphus Demon Bonanza. Better known as Dr. Cid, is a brilliant man responsible for supplying the Empire with much of the technology required for its rapid expansion. As a father, however, he is quite neglectful of his son, due to his obsession with his constant pursuit of knowledge and power. Despite the uniqueness of his work, Dr. Cid is quite a typical workaholic, putting his family life on hold to further his ambitions. He is, nevertheless, not totally without affection for his son, since he had all intentions of one day letting him share in his ambitions and take his rightful place beside him. When you neglect your child in favor of work, however, you shouldn't be all that surprised when your child turns to a life of piracy, or in more general terms, refuses to fit the mold you have created for it.
Rad Dad Number 3, Braska from Final Fantasy X. Just like Barret, Braska is out to save the world, but unlike Barret, the threat he and the world faces is more tangible. Sin being a constant threat to the population of Spira, as opposed to Shinra's energy manufacturing, hypothetically, according to Owlin's propaganda, killing the planet one day. In addition to this, Braska is able to keep Yuna safe while he is away, firstly by leaving her behind in the holy city of Pavel, and secondly by sending her to Bisei to enjoy a peaceful life as a part of the hard-won calm he has claimed for all the people of Spira. Compared to his daughter, Braska may not have had the same lasting effect, but he did the best he could with what he had and laid the groundwork for her to go even further than he himself did.
Bad Dad Number 2, Hojo from Final Fantasy VII. Just like Dr. Cid from Final Fantasy XII, Hojo is obsessed with his work, although he takes the mad scientist archetype a step further, referring to people as test subjects and wearing a white coat everywhere he goes, even to the beach. It is therefore no surprise that when it came to fathering a child, his desire was only fueled by his thirst for knowledge. From his perspective as a father, the child he sires is predominantly, if not exclusively, an extension of his ambitions. The one time he stands up for his son, he claims it's because of their bond, but in doing so he fails to reprimand his child for its reprehensible behavior, thereby failing his duty as a father to properly educate his offspring about right and wrong, and enabling it to do great harm.
Rad Dad Number 2, King Regis from Final Fantasy XV. Regis doesn't actually get a lot of screen time in Final Fantasy XV, since almost as soon as Noctis and the guys leave Insomnia, the royal capital is invaded by the Niflheim Empire and the king killed in the process. Even looking at their supplementary film Kingslayer Final Fantasy XV, there is little mention of their father and son relationship, since Noctis only makes an appearance in a short post-credits scene. What little we do get to see of their relationship can be found in the game A King's Tale, where Regis recounts his earlier adventures to Noctis in the guise of a bedtime story, indicating that Regis has strived to spend some quality time with his son. Another scene I feel is worth mentioning, however, isn't even canon, since it only appeared in the announcement trailer for the game back in 2013. In this scene, Regis teaches Noctis to eat his food, even though he doesn't like how it tastes. But the lesson isn't just about not being a picky eater, but also about respecting the chef, and by extension, the people they not only rule over, but also serve. In the game itself, Regis sends his son away to keep him safe, but his intent is not to coddle him. His last words to him telling him to walk tall, showing the great expectations Regis has towards his son, believing him to be able to take responsibility and to shoulder the weight of the world.
Bad Dad Number 1, Gao's father from Final Fantasy VI. Although not a major character, Gao's father is emblematic of perhaps the greatest sin a parent can commit. That is to say, denying the existence of that child. When Gao was born, his mother died in childbirth, causing his father so much grief and trauma that he abandoned the newborn child on the Veldt, a monster-infested plain where monsters from all regions of the world gather. The Japanese name being Kemonogahara, meaning beast plains. So yeah, clearly not a place fit for an infant to be left to fend for itself. Aside from leaving Gao for dead that one time, the case could be made that Gao was actually better off not having the kind of man that would do such a thing in his life. But a part of being a good parent is actually rising to the challenge and protecting a child that can't protect itself, not only from dangers of the world, but also from the tragedies of life, at least to the extent that not doing so would seriously endanger the child and its development. Failing to do so not only makes you a bad parent, but rather unfit to be one. Sorry to hear about your wife dying and all, but this isn't about you.
Rad Dad Number 1, Saz from Final Fantasy XIII. Saz has suffered his fair share of hardships, not only losing his wife 3 years before the start of the game, leaving him a single parent, but also getting caught up in a government-sanctioned purge, and subsequently being made the servant of a hostile demigod against his will. It's a long story. Well, maybe not that long. But in the face of all that, Saz remains a devoted father to his son Dash, as all the problems of the world take second place to his needs. Not that Saz is actually there to fulfill those needs for most of the game, but unlike some other characters, leaving his child behind to save the world is not a choice he makes, but rather a destiny imposed upon him that he cannot escape. Saving the world by going to hell and back, only being a stepping stone on the way to being there for his son.
Thanks for watching Top 5 Rad Dad Bods.
If you liked the video, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and leave us a comment and like.
Peck, 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 peck